Our rules are simple, but the challenge is great. No shoulder pets, tames that can be carried, or typical boss dinos allowed. That means no Rexes, Therizinos, or any other dinos people normally use in these fights. Equipped with official server cap saddles, our 19 contenders will be backed by the commanding presence of a loyal Uteranus providing that extra boost. All competitors will go into battle with food to provide a healing effect. Herbivores will have plenty of sweet veggie cakes, and carnivores and omnivores will have cooked meat. No Overseer, because the movement speed required to get through the tech cave then chase the Overseer during the fight would shorten our list by a lot. It's important to note that tames in this series aren't typically used during boss battles because of the amount of mutations it would take to make them competitive. I'll be applying around 23,000 health and 1,200% melee through mutations and experience levels to all dinos that compete. This will give them all a fair shot at defeating at least one of the guardians. It won't always be feasible to reach these stats depending on the dinos I'm using, but I will let you know the amount of mutations and levels it took in order to reach it. All competitors start out with 50 base health and melee and 40 points in everything else before I apply mutations and experience levels. Use this information and decide on your own servers if the juice is worth the squeeze. Competitors are required to fight the Megapithecus, Broodmother, then Dragon on all difficulties, starting with Gamma, then Beta, finishing with Alpha. Their success will be annotated on this scorecard with a pass or fail system. Now let's introduce our competitor and see if they have what it takes. Pachycephalosaurus. Captain Forehead here is better known as just Pachy. They're a passive creature unless you provoke them, and it is usually found alone in the wild. This little fella has a thick-ass head that reduces damage when struck in the nugget, but the body takes the normal amount of damage. Both their primary and alternate charge attack increase torpor on the victim. The stats required for this competition were achieved with 75 mutations and 81 experience levels. 50 mutations and 52 levels went into health, and 25 mutations and 30 levels went into melee. I had to use base stats of 50 in health and melee, and 20 in everything else in order to keep this under 450. Now let's see if a 5-head is good enough to win. The green portal was open and the Pachys were about to head into the Gamma Megapithecus arena. They're not the fastest and their damage output is pretty atrocious. They don't do the charge attack when they're not ridden, unlike the trike, which doesn't make much sense to me. Clearly, these guys were not going to be ahead of the curve when it comes to advantage in these fights. The veggie cakes work wonders and they truly need it. Just keep an eye on the clock in all of the fights. The Pachy is able to withstand the Gamma Monkey onslaught and pull off a win, earning their first pass. The Gamma Broodmother was up next, and this one kinda caught me by surprise. You may have seen it a little in the Gamma Megapithecus fight, but the Pachys get close enough and they actually attack, but they don't hit. You'll see it a few times throughout the competition, especially in the dragon fight. Usually creatures that can't hit the bosses would just stand there and not even try to hit. The underheads actually fire off the animation, but their attacks do nothing. They have small hitboxes, but they're still kind of awkward to maneuver and kinda go off on their own path randomly. Their flaws don't outweigh their persistence though. And they take down the Gamma Broods and earn their second pass. Here's what I was talking about. Notice how they're attacking, but not hitting? I have a pretty terrible memory, but I'm pretty sure this is the first. I'm usually frustrated when the creatures don't attack at all, but it's pretty weird to see one that is within attack range, but they don't hit. The Gamma Dragon takes off a ton during this fight, and the underheads hold their own. These little guys really have performed well thus far, and hopefully it doesn't go to their heads because the real hero here is the sweet veggie cake. And Commander Yutes, of course. He's the true hero of the entire series. The Gamma Dragon fight took a significant amount of time, and surprisingly, I didn't struggle as much as I do with other smaller creatures to eventually get in a position where they could actually hit. It took forever, but eventually they put him down, earning another pass. The blue portal was up and the underheads were head over heels to get into their first beta boss fight against the Megapithecus. Let me tell you, this fight was mayhem. The knockback is horrible with the Pachy. Everything was pushing them around and the entire fight I was just running all over the arena trying to prevent stray ones from getting knocked off the inner cliff. I even had to reposition the entire fight multiple times and I thought for sure that I'd run out of time or the beta Megapithecus would take them out. It turns out, the veggie cakes paired with an over 85% damage reducing 5-head is a hell of a combo. If only these little dudes hit harder and didn't require so many mutations, they'd truly be ahead of the pack. It took a significantly long time, but eventually the underheads were able to actually pull it off. They earned a surprising pass over the beta Megapithecus. The beta Broodmother is up next, and these boys struggled big time. I don't know what it is, but they just can't seem to land shots on her consistently, and even the Uranios were pushing them all over the arena during this fight. If Big Veggie ever needed an advertisement for their sweet cakes, then the Beta Megapithecus and Beta Broodmother fights would be perfect for that campaign. The fights lasted so long and hell. Maybe Big Forehead might want to get in on the advertisement as well. I knew that this one would be coming to an end sooner rather than later because the Alpha Broodmother's little sister was starting to get jealous of all the passion that goes on in her big sister's cave with me. She's an angry, jealous asshole, and she ripped through all of the underheads, slaughtered Commander Utes, and took off my head. That's our first fail. Keep an eye on that clock. This one was hands down the longest fight of the series where I didn't actually run out of time. The baited dragon is no slouch, but we can touch Pachy head to dragon toe and stay out of his range. I truly didn't think this one was going to be possible, but I'm telling you, no matter what I do during these videos, I am continuously surprised. The underheads are super weird maneuvering in the dragon arena. They would often run off in weird directions for no reason, similar to what we saw with the scorpion. I'm wondering if there was a recent patch in the past few weeks that changed something with the pathing, or if it's just a coincidence that I had two creatures in a row do this. I guess we'll have to see what happens in the next few videos. The Pachy takes about 3 business days to get to the end, and I really didn't think they'd make it, but finally, the damn dragon stopped taking off. In an impressive and hard-fought victory, the Pachys earn a solid pass. Can you believe it? The Fivehead family has accomplished the unthinkable. We have a red portal, folks, and that means Alpha Megapithecus time. Now, if you look at the completion time on the Beta Megapithecus fight and compare the health difference between Alpha and Beta, it's pretty obvious that there isn't a snowball's chance in hell that these guys are going to be coming out ahead in this fight. They were destined to lose, which is why my super fancy spray-painted armor didn't accompany us, so I wouldn't have to repaint a new set. But I'm not just going to say, hey y'all, sorry, we're not going to win. We have to test it, because you just never know. But I did have to eventually hop off Commander Utes to get on an underhead and witnessed him getting slaughtered, so there's that. Surprisingly, the knockback isn't as insane as it was in the Beta fight, but it's probably just because I was used to it and the difference between Gamma and Beta was so huge. Eventually, all the underheads are down and I'm stuck in a corner with a bunch of monkeys underneath me, and the Alpha Megapithecus puts me into the ground, handing us another fail. The Alpha Dragon is up next, and I did feel like we had a chance. It all depended on if the dragon would get stuck on the ground or not. It was a difficult fight, and during the first attempt, I made some foolish mistakes, got burned to death before I had a chance to determine if it would be possible or not. On the second attempt, I ran out of time, but I did have about 4 landings where I couldn't get the underheads in a position where they could put some effective shots on target. So that brings us to our third one, and as I've said in the past, if I lose, I always at least try another time to make sure it wasn't a mistake on my part. I hit some really solid volleys during this one, and I truly believe that the underheads were able to put out something close to their highest damage potential given our parameters for the test. Unfortunately, the time left and the health remaining show me that it wasn't happening, and after I got slaughtered by his minions, that's 3 defeats in a row, and I have to call it. The underheads finish with a fail. Heading over to the scoreboard, the underheads are awarded a bronze boom medal. If you're new to the channel, gold is for a full clear, silver's for clearing beta, bronze is for clearing gamma, and shit is for shit. I hope you enjoyed this episode, and if you haven't already, please subscribe to help this community grow. I love interacting with everyone in the comments, so please feel free to hit me up with some feedback. You can also reach out on any of the social media that I have listed on my channel, or in the description of the video. Thank you for watching, and I'll catch you on the next one.